Joining me today. My name is Ileane, and I'd like to talk to you today about podcasting. And there's an application that I've been using. It's called Anchor. You can find it over at anchor.fm. You'll find my station at anchor.fm/Ileane. That's Ileane. And I've been using the platform every day since the middle of July. So it's been almost 6 months that I've been a daily user on the platform. So I've learned a few things and I'd love to share them with you today. First, I want to tell you about a site that I'm collaborating with two of my fellow anchor mates, and that's Dr. Dan Davidson from the Anchor Talk Show. Actually, it was his idea to do this website where you can find a bunch of tutorials about Anchor, and also Avi Uniglicht. And they call him Dr. Avi because he is the tech guru over on Anchor. And between the three of us, we're always answering questions and letting people know how to best use the platform so that they can really enjoy themselves and so that they can be committed to their show and their audience. So we decided to get together and to put this site together, and it's called Anchor Bootcamps. And you'll find that at anchorbootcamps.com. But today, I wanted to start off from scratch, from someone who has heard about this app Anchor or who wants to start a podcast, but they need an easy way to do it. So let me give you a brief overview of the Anchor app. How the Anchor app works is allows you to record 5-minute audio segments at a time. You can add background tracks to that if you want to set a certain mood for your episode. If what you have to say is longer than 5 minutes, that's okay. You can record multiple 5-minute segments and string them all together. But one of the most beautiful things about the app is the engagement and the community. People can call into your station and record a 1 minute or less segment to give you feedback, ask a question, or just to join in on the conversation on your station. So it helps reduce the back and forth with setting up interviews and all of that. Now, the other thing about Anchor that's important to know is that there's a 24-hour timeline. But I'm going to show you how you can make sure your content doesn't go away after 24 hours. So now that you had a quick overview, there's a lot more to say about Anchor. But for now, I want to get to just taking a look at the app. And I've got some screen shares for us to take a look at. So, as I mentioned earlier, there is a carousel, and this is the homepage of Anchor. And you'll see there that there's sort of a dial. Your station will be the first one on the dial. And you see there, there's my station. So let's look at the very bottom row. You'll see these icons. One is the home button. Then next, you see the magnifying glass. That's when you want to search. You can search by user, by topic, and you'll see certain featured topics there and featured stations. In the middle is the big old record button. So that's the one you push when you're ready to record your 5-minute or less segment. Then next to that is the notifications button. And that notification just lets you know someone gave you engagement on your segment. Maybe they listened or they clapped, because you can give people applause in the app, or they called into your station, or you called into someone else's station and they published your call in. So there's all kinds of notifications that you can get on that tab, and we'll come back to them in another video. So for now, we want to head to that very last tab there, which is the profile, because this is a big problem that I see a lot of people not taking advantage of their profile. So let's get the next screen share up. Okay, so here's my profile. At the top, okay, you're going to pick your username. I recommend that you pick your own name or the name of your business or your podcast, but keep in mind, you also can add an image. And it's just like profiles on maybe Facebook or Twitter, where you upload that square image, but then the app decides to show it in a round circle. So remember that and maybe add a little border around your image, okay? So pick a name that's memorable, easy to spell, or it's your own name. Then next, you see what your URL of your station is, okay, based on your name. So if you pick a two-word name, then there's going to be a hyphen in between. Let's say, for example, instead of me just saying Ileane, maybe I want it to be Ileane Smith. Then my anchor profile URL would be anchor.fm/Ileane-Smith. You may not want that dash. It's up to you. Now, here's a key piece. The description. I see so many people on Anchor. They want to grow an audience. They want to get engagement. They want people to listen to their segments, yet they haven't filled out the description. So people can't know who you are or what it is that you're going to be podcasting about if you don't fill out the description. The description also gives you enough space there that if you want to make sure people follow you on other platforms, you can add in your username. So for example, in mine, I mentioned that you can follow me on Twitter and Instagram under the same handle that I use on Anchor, and that's Ileane, I-L-E-A-N-E. Then you also get a chance to link out to another platform or a website, or you want to maybe link to your YouTube channel if you're a YouTuber, or if you have a podcast already established outside of Anchor, you can add that. So that's separate from the description. You get to add one link. So I see people forgetting this all the time. And these are people that have their own platform somewhere. They have a blog or they have an Instagram that they're very active on, but yet they forget to fill out their profile. One other key element that's coming right up that I want to make sure that you know about your profile here. Okay. You can log in to Anchor with your social media, your Twitter or your Facebook. However, I recommend that you don't do that and that you log in with your email address. There's several reasons that you want Anchor to have your email. First, every day you'll get a daily digest. Now, if they don't have your email address, they can't send you the daily digest. The daily digest tells you how many listens you got, who your most engaged listener was, what segment most people listen to. So this is how you know what kind of content is resonating with your audience based on those daily digests and also your notifications that you see within the app. So having that email address also gives them contact with you if there's a support issue or when they release a really big update to the app. They will email everyone. So, and they don't bother you with emails. You get that daily digest, but they don't bother you every time some little change happens or if they have a blog post or something like that. Usually it's only a major change where you'll get the email, but those daily digests are very valuable. What I see a lot of folks do with their daily digest, when they see that most engaged listener, they will give that person a shout out. What a fantastic way to engage with your audience. And knowing which segment, let's say you publish 10 segments a day, knowing which one got the most engagement, that's also very, very important. So although you're going to log in with your email. You also can connect your Twitter and your Facebook, which is great because you can share your segments out to those platforms very easily within the app. The next thing that I want to talk about, and I'll skip over the music section. Just know that if you have Apple Music or Spotify on your phone, you can connect those. We'll talk about those in another video. But the next section that I want to bring to your attention is super important. Because even though you may have started your anchor show thinking, I'm just horsing around, I'm not really serious about this thing. Remember, everything is on a 24-hour cycle. If you want to save your content, and even though you may not think that when you first sign up, eventually, as time goes by, you're going to want to save your content because you're going to be building your public speaking skills. You're going to want to be able to track your own personal development on the app. You want to turn on that very last toggle you see there, which is My Station Archive. You want to make sure that Anchor keeps an archive of your station on a daily basis. At the end of the day, in the Eastern time zone at midnight, they will archive your station, and you will be able to go through in the app and still access your old content. That's also a great way to repurpose content. Go back to some of those winners. Remember, I told you, you'll find out through your daily digest what the winners are. So maybe you go back to one from 2 weeks ago and air it again because you've got new listeners in the last couple of weeks, right? They didn't hear it. Or everybody that has favorited your station didn't hear it the first time. So you definitely want to have that option toggled on. So there you have it. Guys, I am excited about this app, especially for folks who want to start a podcast, just haven't got up the nerve or think that there's going to take so much time and there's going to be so much tech. This is super simple. All you need is your mobile device and something to say. Sign into the app with your email address, pick up your phone and start recording. You will get engagement with people on the app. I'm sure you'll see people on there that you already know. And what I'd like for you to do is to make sure that you come back because I will be talking about Anchor here. Also visit anchorbootcamps.com. That's where you'll find those tutorials. You can get up and running. I wanted to make sure you know how to optimize your Anchor profile. And with that, I'll see you in the next video, or I'll hear you over on Anchor. Peace.